Once thought for geoguesser, no, it would be a great thing to just sometimes put yourself randomly into Street View at some area in the world and look how it looks there. If I put your Street View on, then you will find out where is Street View available, and you find out that it's lottery in Europe, not in Germany. USA, Mexico, but then it stops. And then you have a lot of Brazil, Argentina, and around here. Africa is very empty. But yeah, how does it actually look in the northern parts of Australia? I have actually no idea. Right there. Look, it's very greenish here. That's one thing we could do, but I could also sing a bit. Papua-Neuguinea. Oh, that looks great. So everywhere sea around us, just to that you get to land. Alaska. There's actually not as much snow as you would think. I mean, I'm pretty much in the north of Alaska and there's no snow, like only this little bit. Interesting. Huh. If you go to that point here, the very northern part of Alaska. Huh? What? This can't be Alaska. What? But look, there's some like snowmobile. Like even in September, I wouldn't have guessed that. But when you land here, would you believe this is Alaska? I also didn't know it is so flat there. Holy shit. But what is here? Ah, now we have snow. We are not allowed to see that? Okay. We should be close to the water, but I can't find it. Here, Resolute Bay. Oh, there's actually, you can walk there a little bit. There's even an airport. Look. Here's the water. Let's go to that point here in the bottom. Come, load. In the middle of Greenland. Ja, of course. In the middle of the Greenland Sea. Nothing happens. No matter how often click on it. I also thought when GeoVisor did his Norway things, that maybe something around Spitsbergen would actually come up. But there isn't even a street, or is there? Do they have streets? Seems like, I mean, there's Longyearbyen. You would think that this is a street to that. This is the capital, kind of. Yeah, this is a street. Is that long? Is that the city? Ah, seems like. I can't move forward. Like super. Ah, okay, now. I was actually going too far with my mouse, seems like. Ah, yeah, here was the sign. Ah. My God, I hate that. Ah, finally. Okay, let's go a bit south on. How about this part of Pakistan, close to India? Can I get out of that? I don't think so. Xinjiang. Let's go here. Oh. Oh. That's a cool thing. That's like making holidays when you just click yourself through that. Where are actually these cool mountains in China? You know, China has really cool scenery, but I don't know where that is. They have some really interesting mountains somewhere. I can see. Ah, this looks to be close to that. Maybe. Yeah, but I'm speaking of mountains with trees, you know. Let's have a look. Nah. This is not that. Let's Google shortly. Yeah, look. I mean, isn't that looking great? Where is that? Are basically Avatar in real life. But yeah, where is that? Huangshan Mountains. Huangshan. So where is Huangshan? Hier, Huangshan. Wer ist das in China? We still don't know. Aha, it's actually in the eastern part here. It is not far away from Shanghai. Yeah, I mean, we have no idea about China and where there are mountains and so on. But yeah, it is here. This is the area. So if you here get some 360 maybe. This is now on the top. Magic brush with a flower on the top or on the tip. Yeah, those are looking really great. I know you are more on the bottom. Let's go to South America. Or maybe on the way to South America. You find here the Marshall Islands. Yeah. Ja, der ist Fidschi. Französisch-Polynesien. Hiba-Oa. Palm Trees. So green. So. Ja, Paraguay has nothing except a little bit of street in Asunción, and then this little 360s. That is actually on the top of a mountain here. There are like little hills. Ah, but if we go to the west of this country, it's. Okay, I first want to say it looks dry, but there are also just a lot of fields. There's a lot of forest in the background. Looks a bit boring though. What is that here? Major Infante Rivarola? This is here the border between Bolivia and Paraguay. Interesting. Yeah, it just ended with a cast. Nice. Wanda. If you see that picture here, yeah, would you believe that you are in Africa? Would anyone believe that this is Africa? I think if you would do this in GeoGuessr, many people would be completely wrong. Like already guessing that this is the continent Africa here. In Uganda, I also know there is some 360 thing that came up in a GeoGuessr, in a difficult GeoGuessr map. But of course, I don't know where it is. Maybe here, no. It was around the pool. Nothing too great. But yeah. Here. Yemen. Oh, it's not completely desert. There's a bit greenish as well. Looks interesting. There is a also very interesting spot around here somewhere. Yeah. I mean, this is around the spot that I wanted to go for. Okay, this looks different than what I expected. Huh. Yeah, I don't know. Here it also doesn't look that... Yeah, here I can see the mountains now. There was a spot in the mountains where you also never would have guessed that it is here. But I can't really find it now. Somewhere in those mountains. How is it in Georgien? Oh, interesting. I mean, we are pretty far up there. There's of course also a mountain range. It's quite interesting. So I always thought like here in those areas where you have also mountains everywhere, where it might look there. Interestingly, there's a little bit around Sarajevo, but other than that, you don't have a lot here in Bosnia-Herzegovina. Now those are mountains with lots of trees, like hills, higher hills. There's a little lake. That I can't see here. Now I can show you where I often was in the holidays. We are there. This is Hungary. Can show it's Hungary. And in Hungary, there is a big, big lake, the Balaton. So. Balaton, I was often in Balaton Boklar, Balaton Lelle, Balaton Semmes. That is where we always went. You can go to Balatonfeld was a little bit bigger city, and then comes Samadi. And here was a supermarket always close to that point here. This is a very thin passage where you can also go by ship from here to the how is it called? Half Isle Tihani, which is sticking out here. And then the biggest city is probably Siufok here. I never was really on that edge here, never really here. Those are not so known to me. But Johnny is very known because often we went from Balaton Boklar to Fonyard and then went over to Badar Johnny. There is a hill right here where you can actually watch at the lake. Yeah. Oh, is that a drone? Yeah, that seems to be a drone. Interesting. Here you can also look how it looks behind. You see, many like in the back of the Balaton, there are a lot of like these little hills. It looks like a bit like Vulcans, to be honest. But yeah. Also on the left side here, Castalia was never that much. But yeah, Balaton Lelle. If you're very long straight, then or here especially, from Balaton Lelle to Balaton Semisch, there is a long straight. And often I was, or we were, the family were somewhere there. I think at some point we were here in a house somewhere. Other than that, maybe here some point. Lomputka could be, I don't know. Yeah. Yeah, Lomputka sounds familiar to me. So you have here the street. You have here actually also train. It was one of the main or the one of the favorite places to make holidays for East Germany families in the times where Germany was still splitted into two parts. Because East German people were not allowed to go into the western parts. They couldn't get over the border. So they had to go to the eastern, and the Balaton was a very famous spot. And yeah, the interesting thing with the Balaton is that you can walk in 200 meters and you still have only your knees in the water. So you can really walk in a lot and still stand on it, which is quite interesting. So, yeah, that's a huge one. I mean, here you see Budapest and that is the Balaton. So you see it's quite huge. I also saw in my train that I once took from Balaton to Budapest. We actually drove past that little sea here, Velencei Tor. And then I actually saw about it also looks great. They also definitely put a lot of some money into that to make it interesting for people that make holiday. Of course, it's not as big, but you still see it has some hugeness there. Ja. Ja. Dann, where did I get born? I showed it last once. I come from Bad Kösen. Where is Bad Kösen in Germany? I can show you from the top. So you see, it's in the very southern parts of Saxony-Anhalt. It is here, Germany. Right beside Naumburg-Saale. Now actually Bad Kösen is counting to Naumburg. Here we go. And there are also here a lot of little points that you can click onto. Some of them are on the ground, so this is now. You will see now something. This here is called Gradierwerk. There is salt water going down through wood, and this is good for the air. And when you walk beside it, it's good you for healthy because you, I don't know, you breathe that into. But there was some point I remember where you had a view from the top. Let's see if I can find that point. When I showed it last, I found something where you saw Bad Kösen from the top. Now nothing happens when I click onto something. This is not from the top. This is one of the little parks. Here's the river Saale. Ah, here it was. Yeah, okay. So this is now a drone from the top. Yeah, and you see, here is the river, and here. And you see, with these mountains here, especially there, it actually gets extremely steep upwards there to a higher level. Like all this background here is on a higher level. Here it goes drastically down to the Saale. And Bad Kösen is like, it has an upper and a lower part. The lower part here is basically underneath these mountains in the shadow here, yeah. And the upper part is then on the other side of the Saale. Like here, you can go up, and this is also a higher plateau. You see also here that this is also super steep. This is the Longgradierwerk that I just showed. And here you also can go zigzag down to the Saale. And this is a higher level as well. You can see that right there. Yeah, and the Saale comes here. And there's also an interesting spot here where it goes down. And then behind here. And yeah, this is a part that is built now. I never saw that actually. I never saw that. It's quite interesting that we have a 360 picture here, or even more than 360, that we have a drone picture where this area already exists because that is built new. This is a little hill here. And there are a lot of was was Schlitten? Schlitten, Leo. Sled. A lot of sled tracks are going down there. Here at the end, on the edge, there is the death track, and then there are a few tracks down here. Yeah, and I was living in Ups, in that house hier. Ja, that house. Basically, you have here the long street around the whole blocks. You go down here. And then you have here a circle. And there we live there. Here is the football pitch. Blau-Weiß Bad Kösen. There's a second one for the school. School was always. It's difficult to say. This building, maybe. Maybe this building here is the school where I went in the first classes. Then we went down there. So I always walked basically until that point every day when I went to school there. Yeah. Here's a little park. And yeah, up there the street goes to Eckartsberger. There is also a summer sled track. If you can say that like that, I don't know. But yeah. This here should be close to. Yeah, we have a good wine. For a long time, this area was the most northern part with wine. Hope to find a Napoleonstein, but was not able to do so. Yeah, this is this part here. He goes over the Saale. All right, yeah, that is that. I studied then in Leipzig, not far away. Leipzig actually has a lot of street view. First of all, I was living here. This was a big parade street back in the days when Germany was still split. Here was the Rewe where I bought things. And here on the left side, there are such huge blocks in that I lived. You have here these quadratic buildings all the time that you have often in eastern parts of Germany and eastern European countries. And in the end, when I stopped studying, I was shortly living somewhere else in Leipzig. I had to find a very cheap. A very cheap place, and it was around Grünau, and it is yeah, here's the Erste Rewe, it is right here. Ulmer Straße. That building here. It looks so dumb, you know. That really does not look nice. Nah, it's also. Is it correct? No, I was already surprised a little bit. It's not completely correct, is it? No, it is. I mean, I think it looks different now. Was done new when I came. It had more colors, to be honest. But there, right here is Allee Center. which is quite cool. Lot of things that you can buy. Here I was actually, yeah, I was in there. Isn't that the Vodafone thingy here? Yeah, Vodafone. Here I got my Vodafone box with that I streamed for a long time. Nice. Summer Toboggan Run. Interesting. Yeah, and then Leipzig has a lot of lakes around. You, especially in the southern part here, are some lakes, and then also here, right where I was living. Can click here. There were a lot of lakes where you could also go into and bath. Not all of them were allowed to, but a few of them. This one definitely was allowed. But yeah, I had a job while I was studying in order to earn a bit of money, and that job was we basically were well, that is not so difficult in English. And sometimes I actually struggle with the easiest words. Measure. That's so easy. We will measure the height of like the whole area, and with that, me and a second person, we were walking. He was having a device with that he was like with laser. Yeah, looking at Messlatte. Does that word exist? Well, what are these words? I would like leveling board the most. Benchmark, interesting, but a benchmark is something else. Yeah. He was lasering something that I was holding, and it was always he lasered me, then he walked beside me and further on, then he was lasering back to me, and then I started walking, overtook him, and he was measuring in front again. Then he started walking, and then we had like always a starting and an end point, and we could get basically the height difference between starting and end point, and if something has changed there. And with that, we walked a lot. We walked a lot, and we walked often outside of the city around these lakes, and that was pretty cool, I must say. That really made a lot of fun when you were, for example, around here, where there is a little, yeah, connection between the two lakes. I actually walked around these ways here, and the Stürmtaler See right here. It actually looks very cool. That's also relatively big. And we also have been at another lake. It is here, the Geiseltalsee. It also has this interesting island right there. And I also clicked on some point, and it was far above everything. It was a point like here, and there's also this way here. No, I was traveling that. We were measuring here. This is the little lake in between, and it goes very far. I was also once in that middle area. Also cool. Yeah, here was a point, and now he's gone. Yeah. Look, a little beach. Yeah, this was the point where you see it from above. But what you don't really see at that lake is the height difference. I mean, this here is really going uphill. Yeah, it's It's really going strong uphill, right at the lake. There you see it a little bit. It's really steep. Ah, here you can see it a little bit, maybe. It was fun. It was really calm often when we walked across these ways there, and yeah, it had something. It was interesting. I came outside at that moment, at least. Takes always so long, man, to load. Hello? Oops. Yeah, and then I went to school. In the end, I also made my Abitur, and that was in Braunschweig. It was right there. I just wonder. Wait. This is probably too far, right? Actually, can't. Right, I need to make this shortly. Yeah, here it is. This is the school with. Here's the sports hall in there. Here. Here. Oh, no, this. This is the sports hall. This is where I lived in this building for the most time. Here were the girls living. Like, was a boarding school. For me, at least. But there were, of course, a lot of extern people that are living in Braunschweig. Later, I was in that building. This is the school with all the classrooms. We have one. 360 here, but you don't really see a lot. Yeah. Yeah, what just happened in Royal during my story? No way. But I'm not sure if that finish still counted. Probably not, but it is crazy. Like, did he even intend that? I mean, ah. I also had a look. He was actually still in, already in front, and it was not a decisive round. But yeah, I mean, it looks slower than Virtual's cut, so Virtual's way of doing it. But yeah, now I'm living here in Goch. I was also searching for some overview camera, if that exists. But this is, I think, the nicest picture of Goch always, with this thing here. Also a little river. Can nicely walk around the Nias here, the river. It's actually going a bit uphill, especially in Kleve, but I really surprised. I actually want to know now. When we went to Kleve, there was this part here is, I think, a bit hilly, actually. I think it is a bit hilly. It goes uphill there. Oh, also hier. Because you might think it's close to Netherlands and it's completely flat, but yeah, it is kind of flat, but not completely flat. There are still a few like uphills and downhills, no? Also when I'm driving. It's not too bad, at least. Would be nice to know which of these points could be a drone that is looking from above. You see what I mean. Goes a bit uphill there. Of course, in that direction you see flat. But this little uphill, downhill, you see it when you drive by car. Naja. So, one last, where I go randomly on some point. I made some jokes about the 30 degrees that we actually got now in this area here. Yeah, we got here 30 degrees Celsius. I said, like, imagine you would do holidays here later. Nice beach on the White Sea. And weather cam, what does it say? 7. All right. And now it's of course late. Yeah, I don't even know if it would take this cam, but yeah, imagine here palm trees and stuff. How does it look here? Oh yeah, at least no snow. I mean, you wouldn't think you are so far in the north if you look at that, no? You wouldn't think that. Maybe just because of the no trees. But that's it. Here the Big Island Cola. Yeah, this does not look like you're super far north, to be honest. Now, only the fact that trees are missing. Because you know, when you go up a mountain in the Alps, then at some point you don't have trees anymore because it's too cold. And here, so really big trees are kind of missing. Maybe because of that. But other than that, you wouldn't really think that you are so far in the north. Here's actually a beach. Haha. Are there also palm trees? But yeah. Interesting. I don't know what Zabomba is. Don't we have any street view thing on these beautiful islands? We are so far north, but this is the South Island. Hä? And this is the North Island? Like this is one island, or is it here splitted? No way it's splitted, look. Huh. And here it becomes, yeah. I can't open it. Fuck it. What is that even? I never saw this. How is that called? Prinz Georg Land. Didn't know it exists. Look. I can show one more thing. I did once. Before I say something stupid. Yeah, okay, presentation. Yeah. I did once a presentation about. I had to do a presentation about the volcano. And I could choose which one. And there were two volcanoes I thought of. One of them was in the Antarctica, and the other one. That I thought of was the most northern volcano that is existing on the Earth, the most northern one. So now we know, of course, that there are volcanoes along that section here up to Iceland. But of course, you see it also continues still a little bit. No, it continues still. And this point here, this is the most northern volcano that is existing on the Earth. This here is an island, Jan Mayen, and there it is. Doesn't it look cool? It's really cool, right? And yeah, it's the Bären. How was it called? Bärenberg? Not sure. But yeah, can click here on. Yeah, it's also pretty cool there. I mean, temperature-wise. You don't see a lot. Would be funny to have a point right in there. Oh, why did it happen? Yeah, is that the same? I pressed on another one. What is with all those? Not a lot of snow right now. I thought you could maybe see that volcano at some point. But I click on so many and then nobody. No, now this one works. Yeah, not the best weather, it seems like. Like this is always the same group that made those photos here. I mean, on Google, you find of course pictures of it. No? If you click here, was it called like that? Bärenberg, with double E, of course. Yeah, you see it. It actually looks pretty cool. Now you have here these cliffs, and it looks even a bit greenish up there. And then you have this volcano here. It's actually pretty. Oh, this is something else. Also looks great. I mean, holy shit, ey. Yeah. One more thing, I thought thought now. First of all, is there something at the North Pole? What is the northern thing I can click on? I see here one. Is that North Pole then? What? Where am I? Now that would be still a game. Like, where are we? It's definitely not the place we think it is, but where are we? Which country could that be? What? Ah, maybe everyone tricked us already in the school. They always said North Pole is cold and so on. Maybe that's just not true. Incredible. Ja, hier, of course. Yo, in the middle of the sea. That's great. Why, just why? In the middle of the sea. Why did I land there? Maybe it put me to where it really was. Here again, some bananas. Yeah, look where I land. I land here in east of North America for some reason. Even though I clicked on a point up there. That's surprising. Yeah, I thought about the South Pole as well, Antarctica. Again. I can't believe it. Yeah, is that like every point I press on is something completely else? Hey, I press on a completely different one and I got the same picture. This looks more like Antarctica. Yeah, I remember there was someone, he was zooming in a lot in the Antarctica and he found something like a UFO, like a mothership of aliens somewhere. Don't know where exactly he found it, ne? He also was searching for quite a long time, but he found it. This guy, I can't believe it. He put multiple points with his picture there. Here's an island right in front of Antarctica. Oof. Ja. Ja, let me find that. Not sure if it looked like that. Yeah, I thought of something else, but that's also interesting. What's that? I mean, there was a video about.
This disc, you're going to see what look like markings on the disc.
Yeah.
Guys, hope everybody's doing well and having a great day. In this video, we're going down to Antarctica. A gentleman by the name of Chuck shared a location with me right here. I'm going to take you to this location where you're going to see what appears to be a 60-foot wide disc sticking out of the ground, apparently being recently revealed by the melting snow and ice. And here we go. We're going straight to Antarctica in this video, and there's the object right there. Looks like it was intelligently designed. I'm going to measure it here in just a second. You're going to see it's 60 feet across the center. Half of it is under the ground. The other half is on top of what appears to be frozen snow and ice. And you can tell that this area more than likely recently began to thaw out, revealing this intelligently designed structure. That is not some random iceberg or, chunk of soil. That is a semicircle. It's a half of a circle stuck in the ground. You're gonna see in this video, I take some screen grabs of this area. I enhance the photos of this disc. You're going to see what look like markings on the disc. You're going to see a round feature on the top that's very symmetrical. You can tell it's like the center part of the disc. The other half we can't see as it's stuck under the ground. You're going to see what looks like some sort of a residue on top of the ice that kind of go underneath. The residue tends to go underneath this object that is undeniably some sort of a disc. That is an intelligently designed structure. Different enhancements, definitely an intelligently designed structure sticking out of the snow and ice in Antarctica. We're going back to the location here. I put together a slideshow of multiple different views of this object. You're going to see it right in here, and there's a little patch of snow and ice about 200 feet long, and it's right on the top of the ice, or at least half of it is. There's the coordinates right there, and that'll take you right to that disc in the ground. And here we're going to go in closer and we're going to look at it, like I said, under multiple enhancements, and you're going to see what look like features on top of this very symmetrical structure that is 60 feet wide. We're going to stay at this angle for the most part of this presentation. You can start to see what look like features on top of what looks like a dark black structure or dark gray. Doesn't fit in with the rest of the ground. Here you go, you can kind of see that that's definitely a much different color than anything else in the area, and it's out in the direct light. These are shadows, so you would expect those to be dark. Everything else is lit up by the light. That is black or dark gray. And if you look at the top very closely, see the elevated circle on the top in the center? Got a very crisp edge around the outer edge of this object, and the other half is under the ground. And it's still got part of it on this snow and ice. See that residue right there? And you can see clearly some sort of a residue right here. That's something different. It's not snow and ice. There's something different right there. Very good. Here's a good look at it here. And again, this is just enhanced, not altered. You can go there and see it yourself. It's right there on top of the ice. Probably one of the best I think I've ever seen come out of Antarctica with regard to some sort of a machine that's that this area over here is lower, but there is an incline in the soil of about 3 feet on top of the snow and ice. There's a good look at it there. Again, you can clearly tell that that's out of place. That's difficult to tell, but there's no denying that that is a disc in the ground. Here's probably lower over here than it is over there. And we'll measure it real quick just to show you how wide it is from side to side. just over 60 feet wide from center point to center point, side to side. So there you have it, guys. Probably one of the best I think I've ever seen come out of Antarctica.
How often he said the same things, but yeah, quite interesting. What are these other videos? I mean, it says video, but there is no video. Oh yeah. So some random click. What was that random click? Heh? What is wrong with the colors? Is that a movie? Look. Also beautiful girl. That looks great. Yeah, that's it. I'm gonna end here with the stream.